It's going to be slow southern laugh. If you want to cry, if you don't, I don't know what's going to happen. Here we go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard. How y'all doing? Welcome. Thank you. It's Monday. The main cabin door has been closed. Please discontinue use of all your cellular phones, all your blueberries, your blackberries, raspberry, gooseberry, huckleberry. Anything, folks, with an on-off switch, please make sure they're not powered down and stoked for takeoff. My name is Angela, and I'll be assisting all y'all for the next hour-ish. I am also your in-flight entertainment for the next minute and a half. Woo! Thank you. I'm here all week. Thanks. Not such a tough crowd, is it, huh? All right. Because of our interest in safety, we need to go to the emergency equipment aboard this Embraer 145. Please refer to that beautiful safety information card, which is located in the seat pocket in front of you. Follow along, even if you happen to be a frequent flyer. Now to fasten that seatbelt, we'll insert the flat metal end into the buckle. To tighten, pull the loose strap so it fits low and tight. To release, just lift up on the faceplate of the buckle. You know what? So much easier if I just demonstrated for y'all.
Okay, here we go. All right, y'all, we got the Jenny Craig diet now. Low and tight, yes. All right, y'all.
So that's how it works. All right.
Yes, that's it. All right, there it goes.
It's impressive, huh? Thank you. All right, now the cabin is pressurized for your comfort. If there's a sudden change in cabin pressure, the compartments above your head, they will automatically open at an oxygen mask just like this. We'll fall down. It's all good. All you have to do, folks, take the mask, place it over your nose and mouth, adjust it with the elastic strap, keep breathing normally. Even though this bag is not inflating, oxygen will be flowing. Keep using this mask until a crew member advises you that supplemental oxygen, heck, it's no longer needed. Now, if you have to be traveling with someone that may need your assistance or is crying like a baby, put your mask on first, and then you put on theirs. I'll show you.
Now, if you all smile, when this happens, it's less stressful. For example, we're flying along. Oh, look, a mask. That's the small part, folks. Everything goes better with a smile, I promise. Y'all get that here? All right, here we go.
And we're moving on in the unlikely event of a water landing.
Woohoo!
That's right. Y'all have a seat bottom cushion, and it is used as a flotation device. Now, all you need to do is just pull up on your cushion, take it with you to the nearest possible exit. When you do exit the aircraft, hold on to that seat cushion, hold it really close, kiss your butt goodbye, and go swimming. Now, we have four emergency exits aboard this aircraft. That main cabin door from which you all entered in my galley next to me, I have a service door. Two additional exits, they are located somewhere back there. Actually, there's an overhead sign, folks, that will tell you that's an exit. And then when you see everybody else running off, follow along, right? Okay. This aircraft's also equipped with emergency escape path lighting. In the unlikely event of an emergency evacuation, the disco lights on the floor, they'll automatically illuminate, telling you to hurry up and get the heck off of this aircraft. Now, okay, regulations also prohibits tampering with, disabling, or destroying any aircraft laboratory smoke detectors. May I remind you, if you light up, you owe me $2,000 in cash. And Delta says, no, there is no smoking on any Delta flights. Well, after all that and all y'all's attention, I want to thank you so much. It's been a joy working for this company. It's been a pleasure working for all of you. I'm not grabbing two beers and jumping. I'm taking the whole liquor kit and streaking down the tarmac. Thank you so much.
I'm going to get hammered. I mean, forget two beers.